The four-year jail sentence of Nobel Peace Prize winner Aung San Suu Kyi is reduced to two following a partial pardon from Myanmar's military chief. More in this report.
A Myanmar court has sentenced Aung San Suu Kyi to 4 years in jail. The deposed leader was charged with incitement and breaching COVID-19 restrictions, according to a source. President Win Myint was handed the same sentence. Critics are dismissing the case as a farce. Amnesty International said the charges against Suu Kyi were bogus and described the jail sentence as the latest example of the military's determination to eliminate all opposition. The two leaders have been detained since the February military coup. The country has been in turmoil since then, paralysed by protests and a deadly crackdown on the junta's opponents. Suu Kyi faces a dozen court cases that include charges of corruption and violating state secrets. The maximum sentences would mean more than 100 years in prison combined. Suu Kyi's supporters say the legal trouble is aimed at ending her political career while the military consolidates power. The military, however, has previously said that Suu Kyi is being given due process in an independent court, led by a judge appointed by her own administration. The trial has been closed to the media, and her lawyers have been barred from communicating with the media and public. The military has not disclosed where Suu Kyi is being detained.
In other news, China's influence in the Indo-Pacific region wanes as the UN gains ground. That's according to the latest Asia Power Index of Sydney, a Sydney-based think tank Lowy Institute. The index showed China fell to second place after losing 1.5 points in its overall score. The index is based on 8 categories, including military capability, economic resources, and diplomatic influence. The US, on the other hand, topped 6 of the 8 measures, registering its first annual gain in comprehensive power since the Institute began publishing the index in 2018. The index also showed almost all countries lost power amid the COVID pandemic in terms of their capacity to respond to and shape the external environment. But the U.S. was a rare exception. As for the Philippines, it's at the middle of the list, the country's overall score contracting 0.2 points. The country performed best in the defense networks measure, but ranked low, 20th place in the resilience measure, which the study said reflected poor levels of internal stability.
Philippine House lawmakers approve a bill declaring the country's maritime zones amid rising tensions with China in the West Philippine Sea. The measure aims to establish the legal basis by which social, economic, commercial, and other activities may be connected in these zones. House Committee on Foreign Affairs Chair Ann Hofer says the approval marks an important step towards consolidating the country's maritime jurisdiction as declared in the 2016 Arbitral Award. The bill is now headed to the Senate. Just recently, tensions between the country and China flared up again after a Chinese patrol ship chased off a Philippine Navy vessel resupplying forces stationed at the Yunnan Shoal.
The U.S. announces a diplomatic boycott of the 2022 Beijing Olympics. This means Washington will not send any diplomatic or official representation to the event. President Joe Biden was already mulling the move since last month in protest of China's human rights record, including what he described as the genocide against minority Muslims in the western region of Xinjiang.
But this is just sending a message that given these human rights abuses, we cannot proceed with business as usual.
China's Washington embassy, meanwhile, dismissed America's diplomatic boycott as a pretentious act that would have no impact on the holding of the games. Beijing also reiterating that no invitation has been extended to U.S. politicians for the event. As the Communist Party of China lays down its economic priorities for next year, top leaders called for actions that would safeguard China's macroeconomic stability, proactive fiscal policies, and prudent monetary policies. They also stressed the importance of the solid implementation of China's domestic demand expansion strategy. The leaders also noted micro-policies should stimulate the vitality of market entities and the protection of intellectual property rights. This framework comes as advisors to China's government recently recommended a softer growth target for next year of as low as 5% amid growing headwinds from a property downturn, weakening exports, and strict COVID-19 curbs.